Hi, I'm Rob Jolliffe, and this is a overview of using Word templates in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2016. This is both a training video and an informational video. So we're going to go through the use of a Word template and show you some examples so that you could try and do it on your own as well, but also so you learn what they are and how they work. Word templates allow you to use Word to edit your reports. Very simple. You're able to leverage a worldwide base of expertise with Microsoft Word, including being able to search online for hundreds, even thousands of Word templates that have already been written. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Also, this allows you to self-serve. I mean, that's just really why Microsoft is doing changing their ERPs and CRM systems to integrate Word. It's so that you don't have to learn a complicated programming language to make modifications to a report. So let's take a look at that and how it works. So here I am in Word. You'll notice that the first thing that we're going to do today is we're going to add what's called the Developer tab. This is where you get to choose the fields and information that you want to put on your report. So between the review view, there are no tabs in here, there's just those two. What I'm going to do is go into the File menu, go to Options, and I'm going to go to Customize Ribbon and choose Developer. So having done that now, I have a developer tab in my menu. And this is required because I need this XML mapping thing. So let's jump into CRM. So here I am in my Microsoft Dynamics CRM. I've decided that I'm going to do a template for a quotation. Let's go take a look at that. So I've created a quote, sample quote for customer, and I filled it in with some information. I've chosen a couple products. I've put an effectivity date in, it has a total dollar value. Now what I want to be able to do is create a report, basically a quotation for this, so that I can print it and send it to the customer. So let me show you the one that I've done. So if I go into Word templates, I now have a few different quotes that I've created. Let's look at standard quote number two. What CRM does is export that to Word, and if I open it up and I view it in editing mode, I'm going to see basically a fairly nicely laid out quote with different information from the CRM quotation that I had open in my screen. So let's see how this is done. In CRM, what I do, I go into Word templates in the screen that I'm trying to create a template for, and I click Create Word Template. From here, I select Entity if I'm creating a new one. The system is going to give me a choice of different entities I can choose. Now, I want the list of products that I've selected on my quote to be included in the output. So I have to choose the quote product. If you're doing an order, there'll be something similar, order product. I want to have the information possibly from the account, like the default address of the account. So I'm going to choose account. I'm then going to download the template. I could have chosen more than just those, but those are the ones I wanted to choose. So I'm going to get a blank document. But if I go to my Developer tab and I go to my XML mapping pane, on this document, one of the choices I'm going to have is a Microsoft CRM document template. And that's going to allow me to choose different fields from the quote. For instance, I could put the quote description. And then what I would do is I would find the description in the list of fields. And I would put my cursor where I want description to appear, right click on the field called description, and insert it as plain text. Now, if I were to upload this back into CRM, it would have a very, very simple report that prints the quote description followed by a description. I can start putting dates on and other information. But let's actually get a template from the internet. So in Word, I'm going to go File, New, and I'm going to search for online templates, and I'm going to choose quote. Probably if I look for proposal, I would find proposals. There's a variety of them. But as you can see, I found a large number of quotes that have been pre-configured by Microsoft in some cases. In some cases, they're uploaded by users with different formats and looks and feels that give me a template that I can start with. Here's a sales quote with blue background. Let me choose this one with the gray background. So here's my quote. Now, if I go into developer and I go into XML mapping pane, I'm not going to see my CRM in here because I uploaded this from the internet. What I need to do is I need to copy the contents of this, go to the one that I downloaded from Microsoft CRM, the one that I had started, and paste this. And I want to paste, and I want to keep the source formatting. That's going to paste in the quote that I downloaded from the internet. Now I'm going to start modifying this. So let's do a couple of things to it. Customer name is going to be the account name. So I'm going to take this and delete it. This is the one that was provided by the quote template. I'm going to go down to the account, quote, account, customer accounts, and I'm going to find the name. There's the name right there. And I'm going to insert that as a plain text control. I'll start doing that to some of these other fields. I'm going to put the salesperson in. So the salesperson is me, and that's the owner of the quote, and it's going to be the owner name. Next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to put some information in here. Now, I don't need all these lines because I want CRM to insert the lines as I'm doing them. So I'll delete these rows. So I only really have one row in my table. I highlight it, and I need to highlight the whole row. And in the XML mapping, I'm going to go find the XML mapping for the products list. Where is that? Here it is. Quote details. And I'm going to insert a repeating content control. So this is very important. Let me do this again. There's your quote details right there. If I right click on it and I insert content control, the only choice I have is repeating. That's because this is not a field name. This is the entire group of all the fields that go into the quote detail. Now I'll open this up, I'll browse down, and I'll find quantity. There's quantity, so I'll put the quantity in here. So here's a quote that I've already done. I've already filled in all the information, salesperson, shipping method. I've deleted some of the columns that came from the one that I downloaded from the internet, changed a few other things like the font, and now I'm ready to save this. So I'll save this one under a new name. I'll call it Standard Quote 3. I'll put it on my desktop. Standard Quote Version 3. There we go. I already had a Standard Quote Version 2 in CRM. Let's delete that. So back in CRM, what I want to do is I want to do an advanced find. This is how I can go find a personal template that I've uploaded. So advanced find is this icon right here, and I can choose from the advanced find list the choices of what I'm looking for. I'm going to look for P. I type the P and jump down to personal document templates, and I'll hit results so that I see what's in there. So there's my standard quote version 2. So I don't want this anymore. I'm going to delete it. So I click on it, I hit delete. Now, if I go back into the sample quote for customer here, my quote, it might still be in the Word templates list. So I'm going to hit F5 on my screen to just make sure that I've completely refreshed the CRM system so that it is going to be up to date. So let's take a look now. So I have no Word templates in here. I'm going to upload version 3. So I click Create Word Template again. And instead of selecting entity like I did originally, I click upload. I can browse or I can drag a file and browse. So I want to grab standard quote 3, which was the last one that I edited, and upload it. So now the system is telling me I've uploaded that. Let's go back to my quotes. And once again, as I mentioned earlier, if I go into this quote and I look at the other choices, the other commands button, or more commands button, I might not see that template. So let's hit F5 again to refresh the screen. Now when I go in, there it is, standard quote version 3. So if I click that, it's going to generate that quote. I can open it up and I can view it in Word. There we go. There's my quote in Word. Things I'd like you to take away from this. Remember to always set up the Developer tab in your ribbon. Search the internet for templates. You do that right in Word when you click File New. Change the XML mapping to the CRM. If you don't change it to CRM, you won't find any of the fields. Add repeaters inside your tables. Remember, you have to add a repeater if you're going to have something that has more than one record for it, so lines on a quote or a sales order. Use an advanced find to delete your templates. So if you've added a bunch of templates and you want to get rid of them, use advanced find. Remember, you're looking for personal document templates as the type of entity that you're searching. If one more thing that I think you should recognize is it takes about 10 to 20 minutes to do a quote or a report. So have a little bit of patience, and Google is your friend. If you have any issues, use Bing or Google, search for the issue that you are having. You'll find a lot of very helpful information online. Thanks very much, and look forward to seeing you next time.